Hey folks, I'm RedMonsterSC, and in this video, I'm going to review my master mining cheat sheet for Star Citizen. This is a Google Docs spreadsheet containing most of the critical reference material and calculations that a working miner might need. And before you say it in the comments, I know what you're thinking. This is totally spreadsheets in space. I've been tracking my refinery orders in some form for just about as long as I've been mining, and back in June, I decided to convert what had been my Excel worksheet to a Google Docs version so that it could be more easily shared. You absolutely don't need this to mine, but it's a helpful resource to have if you do a lot of mining, and one that I've committed to updating and maintaining. You can find the link to this document in the video description, as well as the pinned comment below, so check those links out, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. So let's dive in and see what this cheat sheet includes. This first page is the introduction and instructions. So first, this is a document that I created intended as a reference for the common resources you're going to need while mining in Star Citizen. Before you get started, you need to make a copy of this document. You will not have access to edit my master copy, but by doing File, Make a Copy, you can go and rename it, have a copy of your own so that you can go update the calculations, keep the logbook for yourself. I include a link to the original document so that you can come back if there's an updated version, or if you break the formulas, you can come back to a fresh version, create a new copy from there. There's also an option of requesting support. You can join the Red Legion Discord server, where you can talk through the SC Mining discussion channel, or send me a message if there's a specific feature or request you'd like to make. I also have ways to support my channel and content creation, my YouTube, Twitch, as well as my Twitter. You can look at the merch store, which has some mining-inspired items, as well as my Patreon account. I have the index of this workbook that includes a link to each of the tabs that's included, as well as a brief description of what you can find on each tab. And then my field color key, where calculations and tables are involved, where I need to get user input, I have those color coded. So we have warnings in red, information in blue, user inputs that you're going to be needing to fill out, those will be highlighted in yellow, and the outputs of that are going to be highlighted in green. I also have a color scale that I like to stick to throughout the document, where beneficial values are indicated in green and detrimental values are indicated in red. I also have my change log, which shows the current version as well as all previous versions and what was added with each. So keep an eye on that. If there's a newer version, just follow the link back to the original documents. This is the dashboard, which includes most of the critical calculations you're going to need during a daily mining session. I'm going to come back to this in a minute because there's a lot of information to cover. This is the refinery logbook. It takes information from the dashboard and reports it out and stores it for later data review. It looks pretty blank right now, but as you continue to use the dashboard and enter your refinery orders, it will populate with additional rows. Note that the second row here is used for calculating the next logbook entry. Do not modify it. It includes my fields and I use that as part of my script. When you got a refinery order placed in for the yield table, it will go ahead and populate this and then automatically saves an additional row. This is the ore locations table. It shows where each of the materials can be found at each of the different locations throughout the verse. As you can see, we have a scale between 0 and 1, indicating the likelihood of that material being in that location. Values with a 1 are very likely to be found, although not guaranteed. And values with a 0 are going to be there, but are going to be difficult to locate. Blank values indicate that that material will not be found at that location. The refinery yield bonus table shows which refinery locations offer bonuses and drawbacks to specific materials. And as you can see, there are a couple of places that are better to sell your material at and areas you'd like to avoid. The mining lasers table includes each of the mining lasers that are available, as well as their size, price, specific parameters like their power, bonuses and drawbacks that each laser offers, as well as the locations where you'll be able to go purchase each laser throughout the verse. The modules and gadgets includes the same information for the passive modules, active modules, and gadgets. And the material price list includes the current refined value for each material that you can find in the verse. I include both the ores and the gemstones. Note that this number is what feeds into the dashboard for calculating refinery yield values. And then my reference lengths table, which has some of the common resources you might need as a miner, including the distance in the Urn Halos, the Universal Item Finder, my mining cheat sheets, as well as ways to join my Red Legion Discord server or the UEMC Discord. I also have links to my mining videos, the full tutorial series playlist, as well as individual videos throughout that series that might be helpful. Now we're back to the dashboard, and let's start with the rock mass calculator. So in this table, you can enter the rock mass and material percentage, and it will give you the estimate of mass and SCU that you can harvest from that rock of your desired materials. For example, if we come across a rock with 7,642 mass, with 45.5% material that we would like to mine, and this tells us that we will find 3,477 mass, which translates to 69.54 SCU of material. If this rock is right next to another one that's 3,225 mass with 20.05% material, we can see that adds another 12.93 SCU of material for a total mass of 82.4 SCU. That is a great mole load. Continuing on, we have the current order yield calculation. Once you have your order in the refinery and the refinery order is processing, you can enter the yielded units of each material, and this will calculate your revenue that you can expect from that order. The example above, let's say we get 8,145 units of Quantanian, which is going to be worth 716,000. We also saw a little bit of Boré sneak in, as well as some quartz with about 1.5 SCU. The entire order is going to be worth 749,914 credits. We can set a refinery location and the vehicle that we used, which will populate in our refinery logbook when we save this order. Now, as you're entering your current order yield, you'll notice that the mining shares and splits table updates based on the values we enter. I have here my recommended mining shares and splits. However, you're free to change these numbers and the calculation will update for you. What I recommend for a ship owner is a 20% cut. That covers the cost of the refinery orders, outfitting the modules and lasers, as well as the process of transporting the refined materials back to sell. That 20% goes to the ship owner, and I think that's a pretty fair cut. I also have a 10% security share. With our group operations, we pay a 10% fee from every order to our security crew. You can increase or decrease this number if you run with a different split, or if you don't have any security, you can simply zero it out and it will update based on that calculation. I'll leave it as 10% for now, since that's what I pay my security crew. I also have a 15% finder's fee. If someone is out there as a dedicated surveyor finding rocks for you, they deserve to get some type of payment. The way I do this is I pay 15% of the refined material that I can bring back from that order to the person who found it. So a 15% finder's fee would be worth $112,000 on this order. I also have a section for other fees or payments. Now for an example, if you're a solo prospector and you request help from another prospector to get your first break, but they leave and go process their own rock later on, I request a 20,000 credit break fee for that first break. You can add that here, and it will be figured into the calculations. Once you have all those numbers plugged in, then we see what's left over for the crew. The way that I do this is I split the remainder but equally between all parties that are involved. So if you have a crew of two, you would do a two-way split, three-way, four-way, or five-way, depending on how many crew members you have. If you don't have the money right now, you can add that to the IOUs by placing the player name here, as well as the value. This is just a convenient way to keep track of who you owe once you can go get those refinery orders sold. As you can see, I have an example row here, RedMonsterSC for 100,000 credits. And lastly, just a couple of little stats. Based on the refinery logbook, this calculates what your total SCU mined is at 92.3 and the total value, 749,914. Once we have all of our information on the current order yield taken care of, we've paid out our mining shares and splits, we can actually save this to the logbook and clear the form for the next refinery order. I have this set up in a script that you can activate using the hotkey Ctrl+Alt+Shift+0. That will save the current refinery order to the log and then clear the form for the next order. So let's go ahead and do that now by pressing Ctrl+Alt+Shift and the number key 0. Now that order shows up on our refinery logbook with the individual values, including our timestamp, location, vehicle, revenue, total SCU, and a material by material breakdown of how many units we refine of each material. As you continue to use this cheat sheet, place in your own orders, your refinery logbook should start to look a little bit like mine. At least I hope. If you've got questions about this cheat sheet, or maybe you have a recommendation for a new feature you think I should incorporate, leave them in the comments section below. You can access this document by following the link in the description or the pinned comment. You can connect with me on Twitch, YouTube, Twitter, Discord, and now Patreon by following the links in the description as well. I'd also like to thank my Patreon members for their ongoing support of the channel. And lastly, like and subscribe if you're going to use this cheat sheet for your mining operations, because spreadsheets are for nerds, and we're proud of that.